Dr. Kovac, can you read me?
Loud and clear, Doc. Kinda told you, you can call me Jim.
As you like, Mr. Jim. I was hoping you could pay me a visit in my lab, as your circumstances and logistics allow. Oh, and I believe I'm to mention that remuneration is involved.
So you have a job for me?
I believe I made that abundantly clear.
Oh, abundantly. I'll drop by soon, Doc.
Davenport, please report to Delta Station. We're going to bring him up.
Guys, we have a scheduled dismantling of the Corona ship aft engine panel for hoisting up to Delta Station for expansion later this week. So watch for falling eyes along flight paths 12 and 6.
Jimmy, the science team cooked up a de-icing spray so your rig doesn't freeze with every bad storm.
We're not getting any younger. Moment back up. Keep talking immediately.
Alrighty. Commencing anti-icing procedures. The spray ensures your rig won't freeze in place the second you step outside. But its protection is limited to storms rated below Cosmo class. Copy? Anything beyond that? No guarantees.
Hey, baby. Quick message, and not to worry you, but apparently I am slipping quietly out of my mind. Today, I spent the better part of 20 minutes looking for a hat that I was wearing. This week, I found my keys in the door, on the outside, of course, my slippers in the shower, and my toothbrush in the refrigerator. Because you know how important dental hygiene is to produce. Seriously, what is happening? Unless the little man is telekinetic and evil, moving objects around with his mind just in order to drive me crazy, then your wife has become mentally unbalanced. So, that's good news, right? Yeah. I got things totally under control. I don't know. Kisses. Hey, baby. Quick message. And, not to worry you, but apparently I am slipping quietly out of my mind. Today I spent the... Sorry to bother you while you're at work, but it wouldn't kill you to take the trash out every once in a while. That was terrible. Hey, darling. I can't believe it's been 6 months already. You'd think it would feel normal by now, but it doesn't. Especially not for Hank. He never falls asleep the way he did when you tuck him in. Turns out you have the magic touch. Who would have believed it?
Hey, beautiful. Just sitting out another storm here. You know, out of nowhere while I was working the South Valley. Barely got to my rigging time. I don't want to overstate the obvious here, but it is brightly cold out here. Not just winter in Michigan cold. I took a deep breath this morning and the hair in my nostrils froze in place. No joke. Yeah, at least the air's clean, I'll give it that. I'd love to say I'm getting used to it, that the cold is growing on me. But it ain't. Since I came here on that ship, I haven't stopped thinking about you, Grace. Not for 1 minute. The bravery to let me go, raise our boy for a year or two, or who knows? You are a very special lady. I could stay as strong as you, and I might just make it through this. I mean, it is rightly cold out here. Love you, babe.
Procedure in progress.
Yeah, Jim Salvietti here. Listen, our remote feeds are confirming trouble with the tram system. It'll take a full reboot at the top of the summit to get it working, and you'll have to manually boot up each substation along the way. Pain in the ass, I know.
This is gonna be one of those days.
Successfully docked. System malfunction.
Jim, our feeds are showing one of the stations is back online. You'll need to reboot the rest of them along the way to get your rig up to the dish. There's a cave nearby that ought to lead to the first substation. Good luck.
Thank you.
restored.
That ought to do it.
Ready.
Yeah.
online.
Let's see what that did. Thank you.
station online.
Looks like the track isn't aligned. I better adjust it so it's heading toward the peak.
Rerouted.
That should put us in the right direction. we're getting somewhere.
Online.
Now we're getting somewhere.
System malfunction. Rebooting system. System online and ready.
Actual, this is Peyton. I'm getting the relay patched up, but listen, I don't know how else to say this, but I think we might have a saboteur on the base.
Saboteur? What makes you say that?
I caught a glimpse of an unidentified person as I arrived. Ran off a cliff before I could get a good look, but I think they were tampering with a relay tower.
Jim, no offense. You're not supposed to go stir crazy until you've been here at least a year.
I'm serious, boss. Somebody was out here.
All right, Jim, I believe you. First things first, head into the relay station, raise the satellite dish, and call up the tram. You'll need your rig for the next one.
Thank you.
System malfunction.
I don't know why I'm surprised.
Rebooting system. System online and ready.
Cronus Actual, you copy? I've got the satellite dish working. I'm just waiting for the rig to come up.
It's your first time up this high, isn't it? 10 months before the Cronus expedition landed, an engineering crew was sent ahead of us to set up that tram system and the comm dish. It was a major endeavor, and as you can see, a marvel of structural engineering. The oxygen gets pretty thin up there, and winds can blow up to 180 miles an hour, so the challenges must have been extraordinary.
Attention, heavy cargo tram is docked and ready.
Okay, now that you've got the rig, use the claw arm to align the relay tower and re-establish contact between the comm dish and Coronis.
Thank you.
except you and Dr. Roman. She hasn't checked in for some time, and if there's any funny business afoot out there, I'd like to make sure she's all right. Do me a favor and check in on her before you head back.
Roger that, boss. Peyton out.
Attention. Heavy cargo tram is docked and ready.
Dr. Roman?
Drop your weapon!
Whoa. Easy now, Doc.
Who are you? Where'd you come from?
I'm Jim Peyton. Just here to check
Where
up...
Where from?
From Coronis. What the hell, lady? Where else would I be from? Braddock sent me.
I know you.
That's right. I came down with that creepy fella you don't like, with the big head. Just hitching a ride, I swear. I barely know the guy. Maybe done aiming things at me now?
Braddock sent you?
I want to make sure you're okay. See if you needed any help.
Touching concern after all these months. To what do I owe such an excess of caution?
You might ask the same, Shotgun Sally.
You've seen it then, haven't you?
It?
Someone in the distance. Watching.
Hard to know what I saw. They say folks start to crack up. Out here in the white too long?
Perhaps. Do you feel cracked?
Can't say as I do.
Then there's something the old man's not telling us. You realize that?
I'm trying not to.
I know how it is. You didn't come here to ask questions. But believe me, James, this place has secrets. Keep your eyes open, or they'll sneak up on you when you least expect it.
It's all good and ominous, Doc. I'm just here to do a job.
That's convenient. I've got one for you.
If you're really here to help, there is one thing you can do. DNA tagger for your pistol. Collects, analyzes, and stores genetic patterns for my research. Want to help? There's an Acrid nest just round the bend. Tag the egg clusters for me.
Sounds easy enough.
Take this. It's a motorized zipline attachment for your grappling hook. You'll need it to get where the eggs are.
Any of these eggs will do. I should do it.
Good work, James. Sadly, I don't have the credits to pay you what you're worth, but you can keep the zipline attachment. I'm sure you'll find good use for it. Best of luck out there.
Braddock, it's Jim. Dr. Roman's 5x5. I don't think you have to worry about her one bit.
Glad to hear it. Appreciate you going out of your way.
Of course. Anything else while I'm out here?
Besides the usual standing contracts? Actually, we did just survey a fairly massive T-energy deposit nearby, but it's inaccessible with your current equipment loadout. When you're back, you should talk to Gale about upgrading your rig with some kind of winch system.
Roger that. Peyton out.
Wait, did I hear my name? Listen, Jim, remember how I asked you to find that servo controller off the Roche's scrapped winch arm a while ago and you sort of blew me off? See, the thing is, I'm gonna need that component if you want the upgrade Braddock's talking about, so if you find it, I'll be happy to hook you up. I ain't bitter or hurt or resentful or nothing. I'm healthy like that.
Just keep coming.
Coronis, come in. Hutchings here. We lost the supply drop we were waiting for. It hit a crag off Shackleton's Peak and disappeared over the other side. Roach is looking for a way over, but I think it's
wrong. Luckily, it was backup medical supplies and not one of our scheduled Class A drops. Let's just hope we don't have an outbreak of anything soon. Return home. Out.
That doodad you were after.
Sweetness. Bye-bye next time you're in the hangar. Pretty sure you know where to find me, and, you know, between us.
Thank you. Never. Neo Venus Construction. Number one in energy. Number one in medicine. Number one in communications. In philanthropy, the most generous corporation in the history of the Earth. A beacon of hope in dark times. Nevik spans the gap of new energy sources. Earth's greatest champion. Mankind's best chance to endure and prevail. Nevik, for your future.
Welcome back. Oh, that's real pretty. Good range, good punch. That's a go-to gun right there. Good. That's a must in my book. The less you gotta reload, the better, eh? See you later.
Hey, Gale. You up to helping me put a new tool on the rig?
Sure thing, boss. With that component you salvaged winch arm, I can upgrade your rig to spec. It's kind of what I do. Just plug any salvage that you find out in the world into the kiosk there and select what you need. Oh, and if you're ever low on salvage but flush on cash, Birdie can swap that for you. They don't call him the quartermaster for nothing. Get it? Yeah, me either. All right, let's get you upgraded. Okay. one's simple. We take some raw metal, we reinforce the hull. Yeah, upgraded your claw arm with a brand spanking new winch. Premium bi-steel synthetic cable, high-end abrasion guard, precision CNC machined roller fair lead. It's compatible with the zipline attachment on your grab favorite. And not just because LaRoche doesn't let me upgrade his rig. This is the stuff. Now get out of here before I regret giving it to you. Kidding. Love you. Enjoy. Don't break it. Oh, and because I'm the gift in giving, I cooked you up a T-energy detector. It'll automatically recognize a thermal pocket in the immediate vicinity and translate the seismic noise into audio. Just listen for the signal and use it to pinpoint and discover deposits. Like a hot and cold game. You're welcome.